Hey guys, how y'all doing? So this video is going to be another one of my uni series, but this is a bit late, but I thought never mind. I'm sure some people are starting uni later, and there's some people that haven't even got anything yet until like the last week of them moving to uni. So this video, as you can see from the title, is basically what you need to take with you when you move to uni. So the first thing we're going to start with, I've kind of grouped them. This is going to be like the most important thing, which is going to be your documentations. So obviously like your form of ID, if you have that, so that will be e.g. your passport or like driver's license, or I don't know, anything that can show who you are. Obviously your accommodation contract, if you're moving to you know, a house that you're renting at, or uni halls, you need to have, you know, a copy of your accommodation contract, because once you get there, especially if you're moving to halls, they do ask you for this, and it's much easier if you have it than them having to, you know, find it, your info for you. Just come prepared. Another thing is to take with you to uni would be your A-level grades. So this will be like your certificates that you've gotten, or proof of the grades that you have. You need this. This is like A-level, GCSEs, everything. They need that in documentation. Now, I don't even know where some of mine is, so I couldn't even prove some of my GCSEs. But what you can do is contact the exam board, and they can, like, I think they can provide it for you. And then obviously the main thing is like your UCAS letter. This is basically proof that you've actually been accepted to uni. So this is good for obviously in uni, or if you're opening up a student account like whilst you're at uni. It'll be easier to just take some passport photos. Obviously a bank card, you gotta have money somewhere. I did take some like cash with me, but the thing with cash, mates, I just use money anyway, so let's not even get to that. Obviously you need your NI number, NI card. This is just your national insurance. Obviously you're gonna need a job, let me just tell you. It's even good to be working first year, or to even come prepared that you're coming to like an interview, or you've already like done some applications and you're ready for, because it's good. One, working is good because you're gonna need that extra money, and two, it's experience, and three, something to do. The next thing that I'm gonna, it's more like electronics. Obviously have your laptop. If not, as soon as your student loan drops, you need a laptop. You can't be going to the library every time to just use a computer. Like, it's just not practical. It's good to have speakers. Now, this would not have been on my list when I was first moving in, but if I tell you the amount of people that play music in halls, yeah, or even if you're renting out somewhere, if you don't want to be pissed off or annoyed, you need to have your own speakers, so you yourself, you can bang out your own music, literally. Always important to have a phone. I like to think we all got a phone, because you need to be in contact with people. Just let people know where you are. Let it be your parents, because you, things can happen in uni. I don't know what you people do, but you may go missing or whatever. Just let people know like where you are. It's good to have an extension lead, because in uni rooms and halls and stuff, they literally have like all the plugs in one area. And let's say your bed is there, but all the plugs are here, it's not gonna happen. So you need an extension lead, right? It's just useful. So you need a printer. I don't know. If you're like me, I needed a printer because I'm not gonna walk up to the library every time I need to print something, right? Yeah, it's just easier. Now I'm gonna talk about like kitchen stuff, okay? So you only need literally like two pots. You need a small pot for like boiling your eggs, or like one pack of noodles and stuff like that. And then you need your big pot if you're gonna cook for like the 3 days. You need something like that if you're gonna make like your spaghetti bolognese, or I don't know what you guys eat. Just to have a big pot, okay? And then you need one frying pan. Make sure it's like a wok, you know, a good quality. All these things I'm saying, you need it to be good quality, because kitchen stuff, like, I never understood why my mom would be buying these expensive pots, but they rot. They rot after like 5 times of cooking, and then when you start burning on it and then try and take out the burn, it just rots. Like, it's just ridiculous. But have like a good wok, because you can fry your egg, you can do your special fried rice, you can do your stir fries, everything, okay? Obviously your cutleries. Have those, have like 2 forks, 2 spoons, 2 knives, one tablespoon, like it's really not that deep. Only deep if that you got guests over, that's the only part. Try and have like one guest at a time, okay? And then have like two plates, just take the ones from home. You don't need to go out to buy new ones. Take the one from the kitchen right now. Go and take it. Good. So two glasses, like one mug, like literally, who's gonna come to your house for a cup of tea? Nobody. Have freeze bags. Sorry about that train passing by. Have freeze bags because if you're gonna be cooking for like so many days, always freeze your food because you never know how quickly food can expire. It's ridiculous. This is like one of the things that I learned from uni, like your food expires so quickly. It's ridiculous. You need to invest in a George Foreman. This is so crucial. Like, it's just so easy to cook with. It's basically a griller. If not George Foreman, just buy any type of griller because you need it. Like, you can just grill your chicken breast, grill your meat, grill your, you're gonna probably even make egg on it, like I don't know, you can just grill anything. It's literally like a quick cook thing. I'm trying to say, you don't really need to buy many stuff when it comes to your bedroom. Try and purchase things once you've moved to the city. So as soon as I moved in, like I went to, like, let's say Primark, bought my bed sheets, you know what I mean, like just things that you really don't need to carry with you. It will just be easier for you to get there. But it's really essential to get a mattress protector because some nasties have been going on, there might be bed bugs or whatever. It's really important to also have, I invested in a memory foam and my friends felt the difference every time they'll come to my room, right? Because it's, you know, just that foamy thing that you put on top of your bed. These beds that students have been on, they've been around for like 10 years. It's literally like shrunk, there's no life, it's just spring. So if you didn't get a memory foam, it just makes your bed a little bit cozy and stuff. It's good to have a laundry basket so you can just section off your dirty laundries. It's good to bring your hangers because I don't think you, I was not given hangers. And where I actually get hangers is I go to Primark. Every time I buy something from Primark, I say, can I keep the hanger? Bring your photos and just put it around your room, just make your room a bit cozy, like you've got your friends still there, your mum's right there, you can just ask her, mum, how'd you make this? Just look at her. But you know, I'm being funny, but like, especially like if you get lonely, just bring the photos, innit, and put it on your wall because it's just really nice. And everyone kind of did this in uni, so you go to people's room and just feel, oh, okay, oh, is that your people? Okay, and everyone like decorates their photos different, just make it all pretty and stuff. Yeah, bring a doorstop. This is really, really crucial because in the first year, you really want to socialize. So bringing a doorstop is literally like you inviting people into your room, you know, when they're walking down the corridor. So don't be anti, just have a doorstop. So, you know, if someone's walking by, I can be like, hi, you live here too? Yeah, literally. Bring slippers. You need slippers. I ain't talking about comfy slippers. I'm talking about flip-flop. Bring flip-flop. If you're not sharing bathroom, whatever, bring flip-flop because you'll need a flip-flop to get into your shower. Even in the bath, I'm getting in with my flip-flop. Are you mad? It's just nasty. I don't even want to think about it. Just don't have your feet on the shirt. That's basically it, guys. I can't really tell you about like clothes, like how many clothes to take, because I'm not the best person. I literally took my whole life with me and now I'm having difficulties bringing it back. And right now I'm going to my third year. If I show you what is looking at me right now, this stacked suitcases, it's just ridiculous. That is my own problem. I'm a hoarder, I know it. The first step of like dealing with a problem is to accept it, right? So I'm a hoarder, I know that. I'm gonna fix it, okay? But like, just try not to take that many stuff. Right now you're going, just pack your winter stuff, and then when you're coming back home, take it back, get your summer stuff. Like, just be doing that. It's not even that important. What else can I say? Then that's really it, guys. If you have any other questions, then let me know. I hope you guys found this helpful, but yeah, I'll see you in my next one. Bye.